Greetings. I completed part one in a direction very different from where I thought the teaching would go. So here is part two, and I'll see how far I get into teaching the truth about God is not a man. In the previous video, I asked, what is God? But not the way a liberal asks, what is truth? Essentially hoping to deny the truth through vain philosophy. I'm asking because I want you to really pause and allow your mind to settle. You see, Christians also agree with Mohammedans. God is not a man. So it is amazing to us Christians when a Mohammedan says, God is not a man, and thinks they have just somehow taught us something new. The problem is that Mohammedans have no idea of what or who Almighty God really is. And you who follow Mohammed have no idea what Christians actually believe. Through gross misrepresentations and gross errors, you have been kept dumb to what Christians and the Bible teach. And it is you, O Muslim, who have abandoned the message of the prophets. So listen and think for a moment, and you can understand what a man is. Number one, a man is a three-part being with body, soul, and spirit. You are a spirit. You have a body, and your soul connects your spirit to your body. Hebrews 4:12. For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. The soul is what joins. It is where thoughts occur. Your mind, your will, and emotions. Your spirit is the marrow, where life stems. Your intents, your intentions, or your motivations. But only the Word of God, the message of the prophets, is able to discern between them. A man is a created being. All three parts of man are created by God. Before being born, you and I did not exist. There is no pool or cloud of unborn spirits. And there is no reincarnation for your spirit. There is no coming back to get it more right the next time. Think about the word reincarnation. The root carne means meat or flesh. Paraphrased, it means that your spirit would again enter flesh. Keep in mind that you are a spirit. That is how you can be separated from your flesh, your body, and still be you. So a man is created. His spirit is created. His body is created. His soul is created to join his spirit to his body. This is not true about Jesus. Jesus' spirit existed long before his body. Jesus said as much when he taught on the earth. In John 17:5, And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. Jesus was aware and knew that he existed before he came to this earth. Father, I will that they also, whom thou hast given me, be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory which thou hast given me. For thou lovest me before the foundation of the world. Do not overlook and bypass that Jesus called Almighty God Father. And notice Jesus said, thou lovest me. He did not say, thou lovest all men or all mankind. It is really important for you in Islam to begin to care about all the words that Jesus said. and the prophets revealed he who would descend from heaven. Proverbs 30 verse 4, who hath ascended up to heaven or descended? Who hath gathered the wind in his fists? Who hath bound the waters in a garment? Who has established all the ends of the earth? What is his name, and what is his son's name, if you can tell? So here in this one verse given by Prophet Solomon, we see mention of the Son of God by Prophet Solomon. And Prophet Solomon speaks of someone descending and ascending to heaven. Who hath ascended up into heaven or descended? When Jesus came to earth, his spirit came from heaven. The Word of God says that Jesus descended from heaven. Ephesians 4:9. Now that he ascended, what is it but that he also descended first into the lower parts of the earth? He that descended is the same also that ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. And the Word of God says that God prepared a body for him. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldst not, but a body hast thou prepared me. As I said earlier, Jesus was aware and knew that he existed before he came to this earth. And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. And that is why we know that Jesus was more than a man. By doing so, Jesus taught that he was more than a man. And even if you only think Jesus was a prophet, you should respect his words and what he really said. If you do not believe what he said, you do not honor him as a prophet. You are deceiving yourself. And this is your true condition if you call yourself Muslim. You say you love Jesus, but you do not know what he really said. You say you believe he is a prophet, but do not follow his words. This is a large part of the deception of Mohammedism, my friend. Mohammedism makes you say one thing, then do the opposite. I'll be blunt and truthful. You simply have no idea what Jesus said. You have only heard what Muhammad alone said. I showed you Islam's ignorant oversimplification. God is not a man, Jesus was a man, therefore Jesus cannot be God. Well, the truth is not complicated. And if you call yourself Muslim, I am boiling this down to put it in your terms. A man is created. Jesus was not created. Therefore, Jesus is not a man. A man's spirit does not exist before his body is created. Jesus existed before his body was created. Therefore, Jesus is not a man. A man has no memory before his creation. Jesus recalls pre-existing with God. Therefore, Jesus is not a man. I know you will have questions, and the teaching you have accepted from Islam will make the voices in your head shout. But the reality is that the teaching of the Lord Jesus Christ is clear. Jesus existed before heaven and earth were created. The only thing created about Jesus is the body that God made for him to use on earth. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldst not, but a body hast thou prepared for me. Another fact is the Word of God teaches Jesus is the Creator. Colossians 1:15. Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. For by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created by him and for him, and he is before all things, and by him all things consist. This is talking about Jesus, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. For by him were all things created, that are in heaven and that are in earth. Him means Jesus created all things. And I understand, O Mohammedan, you are taught this is Paul's false message. You choose to believe what you are told rather than examine and consider the reality of history. Even your Quran says in Surah 355 that Allah would make the true believers superior. That is a good rah-rah speech by Muhammad, but who has been superior throughout history since the times of Jesus? The people of the book. Actually, the people of the book that says Jesus is the Son of God. The people who say Jesus is the Son of God. And the only group that has been as blessed and prospered as much have been those who truly hold covenant with Almighty Jehovah. Even though Satan has persecuted them and tried over and over to exterminate them, the children of God have made Israel, the covenant land, a garden in the desert. Because Jesus was not just a man. Because Jesus was Yahweh. Just as prophets Isaiah and John, peace be upon them, revealed and confirmed. Oh, Muslim, it breaks my heart you ignore the prophets and their message. It proves, O Muslim, that the religion you follow does not believe the prophets. It does not matter how much you are taught to say you do. You do not because you cannot. Because you have no idea what the prophets said. Because you disregard the prophets, you are going to spend eternity in the fire. But this is not what Almighty God wants for you, my friend. God, who desires all people to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. That's in 1 Timothy 2:4. God desires to be your Redeemer, O Muslim. We Christians worship Jesus boldly, because Jesus was not a man as you and I are men. It is your choice whether you accept the truth or accept arguments that attack the truth. I pray that Almighty God guides you out of the darkness and into the light of the Son of His love. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who was not a created man. Amen.